request to the house of God, and be more ready to hear than to give the sacrifice of fools, for they consider not that they do evil. Be not rash with thy mouth, and let not thy heart be hasty to utter anything before God, for God is in heaven, and thou upon earth. Therefore let thy words be few, for a dream cometh through the multitude of business, and the fool's voice is known by multitude of words. We've learned so much about that in Proverbs. Talk. When thou vowest to vow unto God, you see, don't just say things because you want to impress men. Defy not to pay it, for he had no pleasure in fools. Pay that which thou hast vowed. Then I see that thou shouldest not vow, that thou shouldest vow and not pay. Suffer not thy mouth to cause thy flesh to sin. And I say thou before the angel that it was an error. Wherefore should God be angry at thy voice and destroy the work of thy hands? Well, vows are needed. Vows are needful. But if you cannot keep your vows, don't even make a vow. And you need vows for your Samuel to come. You need vow for your Samuel miracle to come. Vow unto the Lord and pay it. Because vows are catalyst. Catalyst to speed up what God is about to do in your life. Hey, daddy, I'm serious. I'm serious about this thing. I'm going to live for you. I'm going to do this for you if you give it to me. Vows are needful. And he said, in the multitude of dreams and many words, there are also diverse vanities, but fear thou God. If thou seest the oppression of the poor, and violent perverting of judgment and justice in the prophets, marvel not at the mat. For he that is higher than the highest, plitus to fragada. We're going to meet someone that says, he that is mightier than the mightiest. Here's he that is higher than the highest, regarded, and there be higher than they. Hey, we can have many mighty men. We only have one almighty God. Incomparable. He has no rival. He has no enemy. Moreover, the prophet of the earth is for all. The king himself is served by the field. He that loveth silver shall not be satisfied with silver, nor he that loveth abundance with increase. This is also vanity. When goods increase, they are increased that eat them. And when good is there to the owners thereof, saving the building of them with their eyes. And what good? Let me take that again. Boom, let me take that again.
Yeah.
Okay, 11. When good increase, they are increased that eat them. And what good is there to the owners thereof, saving the building of them with their eyes? They are just saying it, they can't partake of it. The sleep of a laboring man is sweet. Thank you, Jesus. Can be 3 hours, but it's sweet. Whether he eat little or much, but the abundance of the rich will not suffer him to sleep. Are you the one God is talking about? That because of what you have, you are not sleeping. Hey, the blessing of the Lord makes rich. You have no sorrow with it. You have too much, you can't even rest now. God will not give you anything that will take you rest from you. He's the one that said we should labor to enter rest. Come unto me, O ye that labor, and every laden, I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Learn of me. Learn of me. For my yoke is easy, my burden is light. There is a sore evil which I have seen under the sun, namely riches kept for the owners thereof to their heart. But those riches perish by evil travail. Here we go. And he begat his son, and there is nothing in his hand. As he came forth of his mother's womb, naked shall he return to go as he came, and shall take nothing of his neighbor, which he may carry away in his hand. And this also is a sore evil, that in all points as he came, so shall he go. And what profit had he that had labored for the wind? All his days also he eateth in darkness, and he had much sorrow and wrath with his sickness. Behold, that which I have seen, it is good and comely for one to eat and to drink and to enjoy the good of all his labor, and he taketh under the sun all the days of his life, which God gave him. For it is his portion, every man also, watch this, we're going to hand up right now, every man also to whom God had given riches and wealth and had given him power to eat thereof. That's where we're going. And to take his portion and to rejoice in his labor. How do we end this? This is the gift of God. For he shall not much remember the days of his life, because God answered him in the joy of his heart. I pray that God will give you this gift. This is a gift from God. If it's a gift, you don't have it. Ability to enjoy what you have is a gift from God. May God bless you. May God give you this gift, that you are not going to labor for others. You will build houses, you will live there. You will gather, you will eat of it. You gather fruit, you will eat of it. You will have children, you will be their parents. Nobody will take your place. In Jesus' name. Turn your life over to Jesus. Serve him, love him, obey his words, and enjoy your life. Shall we wait with you? Listen to these testimonies.
Hallelujah. I give all glory, honor, adoration to our Maker. Hallelujah.
Amen.
On Friday, I was about to stay at home. I know it was all night. I was very, very blessed. I was very, my throat, my everything. And something just say, stay at home. I say, no. Something just say, go and lay your bed in the sanctuary. So I pack my pillow, I pack my mat, and I came. After all night, whatever the disease, whatever the sickness, whatever was happening to me, jump out from my life in Jesus.
Amen.
So don't pray, come here all the time. When you, every time God asks you, come in the name of Jesus. I give all glory to him for healing in my body, for healing my soul, for healing my every part of me in Jesus' name.
Amen.